Welcome back to new tutorial. This is Ketul Patel and today we are going to see that how we can create a virtual machine on Microsoft Azure Cloud. So we are going to create Windows Data Center 2016 using virtual machine services available in Azure Cloud. So let's start the tutorial. So here I am logged into my dashboard of Azure portal. Now pretty much good. Go to the left hand side top, create a resource. Here you will, under the compute section, which is the third option, you will find the first option, which is Windows Server 2016 Data Center. If you want a quick tutorial, quick start tutorial of Windows Server 2016 Data Center, just click on quick start tutorial here given down below. And you will be redirected to the Microsoft docs, which will guide you how to create what is the data center and what are the services available under it. So pretty much let's start. Click on Windows Server 2016 Data Center. So here there are four type of stages which we need to pass if you want to create a virtual machine in Microsoft Azure Cloud. First is the basic configuration of your virtual machine. So here we will provide the name of the virtual machine. Let us give YouTube VM. Select the type of hard disk which you want. First is the SSD hard disk, which is obviously the fastest one, and second is the HDD. Let's go for the HDD. Username, create a username for your virtual machine. Created a username as YouTube and create a password for your virtual machine. Yes, here it needs some pattern to create a password, that is one capital letter, small letter, and special symbols and numeric symbols. It must be between 12, yes, and it should be 12 characters. Yes, pretty much good to go. It might be the error because I don't know the pattern is that or it needs only the 12 letter. You can check it out. If you have 12 letters and it's good to go, you can do it. Select your subscription available, which you have the credits in it. Resources, if you have predefined resource, if you want to use predefined resource, then just click on use existing and select any of the resources available. Let's select the YouTube resource, which I already have. Your subscription doesn't support virtual machine. Yes, my subscription doesn't support a virtual machine for central US location data center, so we will create it on East Asia. Not East Asia, then let's East US. Yes, it's East US is fine for it. Already have license, no, save money. Yes, okay. So this was the basic configuration which you need to provide. Click OK and you will be asked for which type of or what size you want of your virtual machine. So these are the list of available categories for your virtual machine. It starts from 4 GB to multiple allocations of your disk, your RAM, your vCPUs, your computing power, and many of more. And here is the pricing table, just look at it before you select any one of it. For the demo purpose, let us select the standard B1S, that is general purpose use, one CPU, 1 GB RAM, 2 data disk, and IOs are 800, 4 GB SSD hard disk. Yes, let's select it. So we have selected that. Click on the select Yes, the second step is done. The second step is was to select size of your virtual machine or the package of the virtual machine that you want. High availability, zone, none, availability set, none. If you want any specific zone, you can just create it, or if you don't want, just go for none. Disk type, yes, we have got B1 as SSD, so we will obviously select SSD hard disk. Use manage disk, yes, this is your network configuration. If you have already created any another network, or if you have your Azure network service created, and if you want to embed it in this, you can just simply go through it, change your virtual network name, your subnet, your default ID, your public IP, all. And if you don't want, if you don't know how to manage your network, then just simply click this, just keep this settings already given by Azure. No extensions are provided. If you want, you can just simply add it. Auto shutdown feature you want, yes. Shutdown time is 7 p.m. Which time zone, UTC time zone you want, or you want your local time zone, you just select it and it will be shut down automatically. Boot diagnostic enable, if you want your boot menu, you can enable or disable it. Guest OS login, if you want, you can enable it or otherwise disable it. This is your diagnostic storage account. All the details are mentioned here. If you want to create, you can create it. Just simply press OK. Automatically, it will give the name to your storage, diagnostic storage account. Manage service identity, register Azure directory. If you have created Azure Active Directory service and you want to embed it here, you can just click simply yes and you can embed it here. Backup, if you want backup of your, if you have multiple datas which need to be backup daily or weekly, then you just click enable backup option and it will be enabling your backup services. Pretty much good. It is giving us the final summary of which services we have selected, what configuration we have selected, and you can read it. If you have changed, you can go to that step, you can change it. So click I agree, create. So you can see it is submitting your deployment over East US data center. You can find it here, submitting your deployment option. It will take some time to deploy it. First, let it be deployed. So here your deployment is completed on the location of your data center on Azure Cloud. So now you can see your resource. You can get many of the option on the left hand side. You can go through it in further videos. We will go through it. So here now we have created the resource, but now you are getting the question that how will we connecting this resource to access it. So yes, in your system, go to the start menu and type remote desktop, and you will find a remote desktop connection application installed in your system already, which is provided by Microsoft Windows. So click on it, and here you will find the IP address in your resource. Just copy it and paste it over here and click connect. So now it will be asking for the credentials. So remember the credentials that you have created while creating this resource in the basic configuration option. Go on the more choice option here down, and here use a different account. Type the username. Which you have given, and the password. Click OK. So it will ask you for the verification. It will be your certificate on your computer will be installed on the name of your virtual machine name, and after allowing your remote desktop to yes, it will configure the remote session and you will be given the access to use your remote desktop connection. So this is the Windows Data Center 2016, which you have created on your Azure cloud, and now you will be using that using the remote desktop connection software on your local system. But you need the internet connection to access it. So this was the tutorial that how you can create a virtual machine, how you can add the configuration to your virtual machine, and how you can connect your virtual machine using your local system using the software name remote desktop connection that is already given by Microsoft when you install the Windows. So this was pretty much good about virtual machine of Windows Data Center 2016. If you are getting any error or if you are stuck in some of the part of creation of Windows Data Center or any of the virtual machine, then you can comment down below. I will get back to you on that query. And if you have any doubt, you can just mention in the comment. So if you like the video, press the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay connected for more tutorials. Thank you.